Merry Christmas and welcome, family and friends, to our virtual Christmas worship. We're so glad that you're joining with us this day. During worship, please feel free to join with us in speaking the prayers and responding to the psalms and singing out loud just like you would here at church. And if you get bored, you can stare at your own ceilings, looking like you're meditating on the lights right here at LCC. A little bit later in the service, we're going to have communion and candlelight service. So if you'd like to participate in that, it's a perfect time to pause the video and get some bread and a cup with wine or juice and some candles if you have some, and then join us for that in the service in just a little bit. Let's worship.
As on the first day of creation, on this Christmas day, the Word illumines the world, shining forth to bring all things into being. Today we celebrate the incarnate Word, God becoming flesh, to live among us in the person of Jesus Christ then and now. Emboldened by the good news of Christ's birth, along with the shepherds Mary and Joseph and all witnesses to the light of Christ, we declare to the world that we have seen and been transformed by the arrival of the salvation of our God. O come, let us adore. Be with you and also with you. Please pray with me. Almighty God, you made this holy night shine with the brightness of the true light. Grant that here on earth we may walk in the light of Jesus' presence and in the last day wake to the brightness of his glory through your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Let us listen with anticipation to God's word.
O
A reading from Isaiah. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in a land of deep darkness, on them light has shined. You have multiplied the nation. You have increased its joy. They rejoice before you as with joy at the harvest, as people exult when dividing plunder. For the yoke of their burden and the bar across their shoulders, the rod of their oppressor, you have broken as on the day of Midian. For all the boots of the tramping warriors and all the garments rolled in blood shall be burned as fuel for the fire. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness from this time onward and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
From Psalm 96 responsively. You're invited to speak the alternate parts out loud. O sing to the Lord a new song. Sing to the Lord all the earth.
Sing to the Lord. Bless his name. Tell of his salvation from day to day.
Declare his glory among the nations, his marvelous works among all peoples.
For great is the Lord, and greatly to be praised. He he is to be revered above all gods.
For all the gods of the peoples are idols, but the Lord made the heavens.
Honor and majesty are before him. Strength and beauty are in his sanctuary.
Ascribe to the Lord, O families of the peoples. Ascribe to the Lord glory and strength.
Ascribe to the Lord the glory due his name. Bring an offering and come into his courts.
Worship the Lord in holy splendor. Tremble before him, all the earth.
Say among the nations, the Lord is king. The world is firmly established. It shall never be moved. He will judge the people with equity.
Let the heavens be glad. Let the earth rejoice. See the sea roar and all that fills it. Let the field exult and everything in it.
Then shall all the trees of the forest sing for joy before the Lord, for he is coming, for he is coming to judge the earth.
He will judge the world with righteousness and all the peoples with his truth. Let us sing together to remember we are all God's children. Kids, get in place for a children's message.
Jesus loves me, this I know.
I have some really exciting things to share with you.
I've been running around all week finding gifts to bring to baby Jesus.
Because that's who we're celebrating tonight, right? That God came into our world through baby Jesus. And babies sure need a lot of stuff, right? Have you ever had a new baby in your family? Did you ever get gifts for that new baby or for the baby's parents? They need some stuff, right? So let me show you what I got. I've got a lot of cool stuff. A bottle warmer. Very nice for those late night feedings, huh? Hope they can plug it in. Let's see, we've got a soft baby blanket and a little stuffy, good for snuggles. I was thinking of Mary. And giving birth is a lot of work, so I brought her a vanilla bean candle, super nice, relaxing, and some new slippers. I didn't know what size baby Jesus would be, but I just figured he'd grow into them, and all babies need diapers, right? Oh, super important for new parents, coffee and ibuprofen, right? Oh, and I just couldn't resist. Little baby shoes. I know babies don't need them, but they're so cute. I hope Jesus likes all of these things. I know they're not big or flashy, but they're what I had, and I thought maybe he and his parents would find them useful. You know, now that I think about it, God is always using just the average and everyday stuff in our lives to make a difference, right? And God has always kind of used average everyday people too, right? If we think about the shepherds, you know, they weren't powerful or rich or famous, but God still shared the good news of great joy with them through the angels. And if we think about Mary, you know, she wasn't famous or anything. She might be wasn't even much older than your brothers or sisters. And if we think about Joseph, he was a pretty normal guy too. So maybe that's how God works. God just uses the gifts that we bring to bring love and hope and light and joy into the world. Whatever we bring God, God's gonna use it. Isn't that wonderful? Did you know that your gifts are needed and matter to God?
Did you know that you matter to God? What kind of gifts would you like to bring to baby Jesus? Maybe you want to bring, you have a huge collection of LOL dolls. Those are super cool. Maybe you're super good at Minecraft and you want to tell Jesus all about it. Maybe you're really good at making animals and shapes out of Play-Doh or coloring. All of these gifts are precious and matter to God. Because when we combine our gifts, you know, if you think of each gift like the light from one candle by itself is bright, but when we have a whole bunch of candles gathered together, our light shines even brighter. So bring your gifts, whatever they are, to our beloved baby Jesus. God will use you to write the story of love and joy and hope and peace in this world. Thanks be to God. Will you pray with me? Dear Jesus, thank you for writing your story through us and in us. Thank you for coming into this world as our baby Jesus. Help us to bring your love and light and joy to everyone who needs it. And may we join with all the angels singing and praising you and proclaiming glory, glory to God in the highest and peace to God's people on earth. Amen. Merry Christmas, guys!
Let's sing together and welcome the gospel. Gospel according to St. Luke. Glory to you, O Lord. In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration and was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged, and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son, and wrapped him in bands of cloth, and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn. In that region there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favors." This is the gospel of our Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. Merry Christmas, and grace to you and peace from God our Father, and from our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Well, I thought if ever there was a year to give a different type of Christmas message, 2020 would be it. I'm coming to you live on tape from this beautiful animal shelter, sort of half barn, if you will, and got some friends out there in the background. It's fun to think about the gospel, about the good news of Jesus out in the world, and not just
in the building of the church. But 2020 certainly has been a year of different things, of strange times, of giving up some activities and regular rhythms that we hold dear. It's been a time of new practices at work and school, but it's also a time where we've had to give up some things too. I hope, like me, that you have had some opportunity to reflect upon the gifts that we've been given this strange year. Maybe you've spent more time with your family or your children or your spouse than you have in a long time. Maybe you've discovered some new things about yourself in your workplace. Maybe you've used this past year to refocus on the priorities in life, because so many distractions that are a part of our regular lives have slowed down or come to a halt in 2020. I've come to think of this year as both a good year and a strange year, but also a year of gifts. So I've wanted for a lot of years to give a Christmas message, not from a stable or from an animal shelter, but I've wanted for so long to share with you the story from Luke's gospel that you just heard, to share with you some of the details that Luke put in his story that have taken on a life of their own over a couple thousand years. So any one of us, if we have any familiarity at all with the Christmas story, we have this beautiful image in our mind that's been shaped by music and song and images and nativity scenes and all of the things that we've come to know as the Christmas story. And usually the story goes something like this. Mary and Joseph take off from their hometown up in the north, called Nazareth, and they travel to the south in the southern region called Judea, and they're going to the city Bethlehem because Joseph descends from the family in the line of King David, who is from that region in the south, in the Bethlehem region. And so they have to travel south because of this significant census that the emperor has established. The emperor wants everyone to be counted, so he knows who his subjects are, and so he can tax them accordingly. And so Joseph and Mary take off from the north, from Nazareth, and they go down south. And when they get there, and this is the story that we keep in our minds, it's the image I think we all have, they go to the Super 8 or the Motel 6 or whatever. They go to the inn, and Mary is about to have her baby. But there's no vacancy. There's no rooms at all. So in this image in our head, this story, maybe it's the innkeeper who says, well, I don't have any rooms for you here. I see your wife's about to have a baby. Or maybe they weren't even married yet, but she's ready to go. And I have this barn or this stable out back somewhere, away from everybody, apart from the inn. Maybe it's on a hillside, far away, and there's animals all around. In fact, there's a big orange cat around my feet right now. And it's a beautiful, clear, starlit night, and they're there alone in this dark pastoral setting, and Mary gives birth to Jesus. And there's animals and twinkling stars, and that's this image we have. And maybe there are three men from the east standing nearby who look and sound different, bringing gifts for a king, and maybe there's a big bright star overhead that guided them. And I love this story. I love the image. And I don't think it should necessarily go anywhere. But this year, the story I've wanted to share with you for so long as a preacher is the story as Luke told it, without all the layers, the generations of embellishments and changes. So the story, we think, happened a little bit more like this. Mary and Joseph left the north country. They left Nazareth, and they traveled down to Judea, but they weren't going to a hotel. They weren't looking for the Super 8. In this time and in this place, the Palestinian customs thousands of years ago, they would have been traveling to stay with family. Because Joseph descended from the line of David, he had ancestors and relatives, maybe close, maybe distant, but he had family there. And they would have expected them and opened their home to Mary and Joseph, especially if she's pregnant, and especially if Joseph descends from the line of David, they would have been honored to be received into a relative's home. And so it's different. They didn't show up at a hotel and Joseph forgot to make the reservation. They went and stayed with family, as would have been the custom. And the story tells us that there was no room for them in the inn, right? And that's where the idea of a hotel comes along. But actually, this word for inn, it means something different. The time came for Mary to deliver her child, and she wraps him in bands of cloth and lays him in the manger, right? A feeding trough, a place where animals gather around and eat. And in this day, that probably would have been an open sky area in a courtyard within a private home. 2,000 years ago, the homes looked a little like this. There would have been a gate or an entry point through which people and guests and friends and family would have passed along with their animals, their traveling companions, and they would have moved into that area, and there would have been an outer covered courtyard where the animals stayed, and in the middle there would have been this open sky, a feeding area. And we're told there was no room for them in the guest area of the home. What that means is they weren't treated as guests. They were welcomed into the private inner room, the private living space of the people, the relatives who owned the home itself. They would have been given the gift of being welcomed into this private space and intimate space for Mary to deliver her child. And where does this new family go? Because there's nowhere around to lay the baby that's soft and comfortable. They took him into this open sky outer courtyard surrounded by family and relatives. Imagine your own home on a regular holiday, Christmas season maybe. Maybe not in 2020, because our lives are so different this year, but imagine your home filled with all your relatives, grandparents and aunts and uncles, cousins and random boyfriends or girlfriends and all kinds of people, right? The fridge is jam-packed. And if you have a second fridge, that's full too. And there are card tables and kid tables and extra sections of your dining table are inserted and spread out, and there's chairs everywhere. And there are air mattresses and sleeping bags, and people are lining up in the morning to take their showers. You look at the counter space and there's food and goodies everywhere. And there's noise and there are games being played and there are vigorous discussions borderlining on arguments happening in one room and others crying together, remembering someone, a member of the family who had died. Just imagine this full picture of family and relatives and food and community and communion all gathered in one place. And a relative shows up who's about to have a child. And that baby, instead of being born out here alone, maybe with a horse or a cat, isolated in an animal shelter, instead, Luke is telling us Mary and Joseph were received by family, and Jesus was born into the loud mess of what it means to be human, of what it means to be family, of what it means to be God with us. Isn't this a different story? And isn't this a beautiful story for 2020? Jesus is born right into our lives, a child born unto us. This day, as sure as he was born 2,000 years ago, he was born right into our lives, right into our homes, right into our families, not in a far-off, quiet, isolated place alone. But there were so many people, so much joy and family gathered that they had to lay him in the manger. I love the story this way too. I think the good news of Christ for us this year, his birth, is that when we're working from home or we're quarantining or maybe we're separated from our extended family by long distance, Jesus is born to us right where we're at with all the stuff of life, with our sadness and pain, with our joy and our feasting, with our Zoom calls and our storytelling and our political arguments and our pumpkin pie. Jesus is born unto us right where we are. This is the child God has given to us right into our lives. May your heart be blessed with the Christ child right in you, shining in your life, radiating out to your family and to the world. May this Christmas be blessed because Jesus is right with us. Emmanuel. Amen.
Voices with the song of the angels, let us pray for the church, the world, and all who are in need.
God of mercy, hold us.
let your church throughout the world proclaim this good news over the hills and everywhere. Unite the voices of all your faithful people in songs of praise and rejoicing. The angels sing, "Peace on earth. Come quickly to still the strife of this world. Hush the noise of war and violence in places of unrest. Inspire leaders of nations to seek lasting peace and sustainable provision for all in their care. God, in your mercy."
God of mercy, hold us in love. God of mercy, hold us in love.
Mary sings melodies of comfort to her newborn child. Bring rest and assurance to those facing struggles this night. Shelter travelers and those without homes. Console those who lie awake due to pain or anxiety. Heal the sick or hurting. Love sings through the sound of a newborn baby's cry. Bless new parents and expectant parents. Comfort those who long for children, especially those running out of hope or options. Surround families of every shape and size with your love and care. God of mercy, come quickly to us with grace upon grace as we lift these and all our prayers to you in the name of Jesus. Amen.
God of mercy, hold us in love. God of mercy, hold us in love.
At this time, we want to say thank you so much for your ongoing support of the mission of the church. If you'd like to make a Christmas love offering, please visit the Giving tab on our website or by mailing in your gift. Let's enjoy the special music.
Hope was born this night.
Now is the time for communion. Please make ready your bread and cup if you haven't already. You can choose someone to preside at your table at home and follow along with me in speaking the words of institution here. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. We lift them to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give our thanks and praise. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread. He gave thanks and broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup. He gave thanks and he gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. The Word made flesh is revealed in a manger in simple bread and wine. Receive Christ in this meal, his body and blood given and shed for you. Amen.
Portion of the candlelight portion of the service. Feel free to light a candle and join with us at home. You are welcome to read the bold parts responsively. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light.
The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it.
Those who dwelt in the land of deep darkness, on them light has shined.
We have beheld Christ's glory as of the only Son from the Father.
For to us a child is born, to us a son is given.
In the Word was life, and the life was the light of all people.
Calm, all is bright, round
Grace from God's own heart, peace from the child in the manger, and strength from the Spirit of life be blessings for you today and forever. Amen. Let's sing.
Peace. Live and love like Jesus.
Thanks be to God.